In the process, Butler became the first South African since 1950 to hold two major world crowns at the same time. As though that was not enough achievement on its own, Butler became the first local fighter under the South African Boxing Act of 2001 to win the Ring Magazine belt and three world titles simultaneously.
Victor Will is the last South African to hold the Ring Magazine belt, and to my knowledge, this is the second African in boxing history. Maybe Dick Tiger, I'm not sure about the date, to hold the Ring Magazine belt. So this is a monumental victory. And bearing in mind, we had to go to the champion's backyard, the Lion's Den, to win this fight, which we did convincingly.
This was a redemption for Butler, who lost against Milan Milindo last year in the Philippines for the vacant IBF title.
I know it was hard work, hard fight, tough fight. I feel the preparation, the hard work we did in the gym, Colin's game plan was absolutely brilliant, and it worked out. It's much better. I fought the better opponent, the better guy. I beat the better guy, beating him number one guy in the division. And it's bittersweet, and it feels good, especially to be a South African right now.
In a year where South Africa is celebrating the centenary of Nelson Mandela, the chairman of Boxing South Africa says Butler's victory typified the South African spirit of never giving up.
After the last disappointment, it had to prove a point that there is resilience. In the last certain fights that I've seen Heki, where at one time you think Heki is gone, like now where he's knocked down, in the previous fights he had been knocked down, and to show the heart of a true South African warrior, he stood up and win the fight.
Butler is likely to have a rematch with Roichi Takuchi. However, nothing is yet final. Joseph Muhali, SABC News, Johannesburg.